हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। वेरी नाइस टू सी ऑन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस एंड होप फॉर द लास्ट थियरी यू हैव डाउनलोडेड एंड यू हैव गॉन थ्रू इट एंड नो डिफिकल्टीज आई बिलीव बिकॉज थियरी वॉज क्वाइट एक्सप्लिसिट एंड you have gone through the theory from the textbook also. In case of any difficulties, don't hesitate to call us anytime so that you can produce the material perfectly, clearly in the examination also. No doubts, difficulty should not be kept hidden or later should not be claimed that it's not explained for the correct reference or correct meaning as such. You have any difficulties, anytime you can call. And one thing for the subject software engineering, as decided by both of the department ISE and CSE, for the unit 3 designs, for the unit 3 designs, design engineering, for the part 2 agile methods only from the textbook summer will, otherwise the design engineering completely, the context model, interaction model, the design with the context of software engineering, design process and the design quality, design concepts, abstraction, architecture, patterns and modularity, information hiding, fundamental aspects to be considered for functional independence, refinement of the architecture, refactoring the agile software. The next topic switches to agile development. So agile development and methods only taken from the Somerville textbook, otherwise from the beginning what I just now read, the design engineering completely is from your reference book, that is reference book number 1, that is Roger Pressman. It's taken from Roger Pressman. Don't go for don't go, but if you are interested you can go also, but the other textbook like Rajib Mal and Pankaj Jalote are mostly not referred for the explanation because theory is very elaborative, very explanatory. So for that reason, Somerville is more than enough for the textbook as such. But the in the reference book, Roger Pressman, the 9th edition. If you don't have, you just call me. I'll send you on the either WhatsApp or on the Google Mail or so as an attachment. The PDF textbook only I have, Roger Pressman. I'll send it to you. Otherwise, if you don't have a textbook copy, Somerville, also, if you don't have, I have a copy of, PDF soft copy, I have Somerville, that also I will send it to. And most of your friends, I believe, including your CR, has copied the textbook from me, you can share among yourself. Otherwise, if you don't have, you can directly talk to me, I will send to you. Roger Pressman and Somerville, both are the books for your SWE and for the study of this complete syllabus of the fourth semester for software engineering as such. No doubts, no difficulties, no confusion, right? Then we'll go for the subsequent theory of the last unit, that software testing. We were here, that is development testing. I have explained to you in the last class about what is testing, the need for the testing, and the mode of testing, the classification of testing, why testing, the testing results, and how testing affects the software development, that too, the professional software development as such. I have explained to you very elaboratively. If you have any doubts, you can call me, send me a WhatsApp message, or whatever the means. Otherwise, you can message me. Whatever the way best possible, I will definitely help you to solve the difficulty in understanding topics. I showed the presentation in the last class what we had referred. We will continue the topic where we had left exactly. So, based on the main objectives, these all testing methods we have gone through, and as such testing process has two distinct goals. In case of the question, what are the main objectives of testing, what is the main goals of testing, or what is testing, define testing, or all the cases, you can refer these statements, and which are very ideal for your explanation. The core diagram of testing, in case of correct test, in case of errors. So this is a classic difference between the two aspects. Inputs which have deficiencies or anomalies or errors inputs, the classic example I can say you, in case of in last class also we have discussed. In case of integer inputs, you are giving the characters, or in case of the decimals, you are putting the integers, then it is an anomaly or a problem or a wrong or error which behaves and it gives a wrong result. And in this meantime, if you have a correct input, it should give the correct output. So to distinguish whether the software, you have developed the software to classify the errors, or erroneous input with the correct input, whether your software is able to distinguish first the correct input or the wrong input, then it can go for the correct output, the wrong output. Correct output, wrong output. Correct input, wrong input. So this is how we have to go for in the implementation in the software test, in the software design as such. So even the TDD, the acronym stands for test driven design. So there also the implied meaning is, so you go according to the test phases and you design the software, which is the perfect software, which is having no anomalies, which is having no errors. It will accept. Anytime it will not accept erroneous inputs, so that you can prevent the output causing errors. There are, of course, thousands of wordings or definitions or lines we can create based on this explanation alone, but ultimately the testing is to mitigate or to reduce or to cut down the errors in the total processing. We'll talk about this interface in one or the other. Rest all I have explained what are the functionalities to be tested. In the last class we have discussed it in detail. Because software you are designing with the functional and non-functional requirements, the functionality to be tested along with the non-functionality. But of course, non-functionality in the sense they are of no use is not the meaning. Non-functionality means during the processing time it will not come into account, but at the back end you have to take care of this one. Based on this, the front end, that is the process, is working. The process is working for the purpose. At the back end you have to take care of these formalities. This is the correct distinction between functionality and non-functionality. This we have discussed in our the fourth or fifth class, I believe so, earlier classes, unit number 1, or during the second unit after the 10th class, 9th or 10th class, where we have distinguished non-functional and the functional requirements, why the requirements you have to, and then it is the supplement or it is a basic necessity of developing the software based on the functionalities and what are the non-functional requirements, the supporting parameters that those are required, that we have discussed in the chapter 2 or unit 2. Well, in the last class we have come up to the development testing. What is the development testing and what for the development testing and how the testing helps the software development, how the testing helps software development also. Means once a total software is ready, then we cannot go for testing it. Before to that, we also have some parallel methods during the development time so that we can cut down the testing phases or the cut down the later errors which are hidden inside the software or a package, the total package, which is having thousands of lines, lakhs of lines. You may be having some problems later on to search in or go for investigating where exactly it is having the problem. So instead we can have a check or a counter on the software development time testing. So it is called as development testing. Even the software testing phase or the during the software testing distinction, the core distinction of software testing is also done in two categories. That's the reason I was telling it is just one unit for you, but it is a textbook or one subject for you in your higher semester. Here it is one chapter or one unit for you, but in a higher semester you have one lab also, you have one theory also, one theory in the sense one subject also towards software testing. There you are studying software testing in very very detail, very much detail, compared to the what you are studying here as a basics, what exactly you need for testing. It's the basics. Based on this you are going for an advancement in your higher semester. Software testing, it's basically these are the core distinctions between software testing as a black box or as a white box. Meaning is, black box is once what we were just now talked about, that is, once total software is ready, then you go for testing. Then you go for testing. Otherwise, it is very difficult to intrude into or investigating the thousands of lakhs of lines of code once the software is ready. So that becomes a black box. Black box in the sense, it is purely in the textbook he writes it as a time bomb. Means, you once the error explodes, then only you'll get to know that there is software, the problem in the software. Otherwise, you don't get to know there is a problem in the software. There is an error in the software. So this is purely a time bomb, that's black box. In case of white box, it is the module by module, the phase by phase of the project. You are checking out the code line by line, whether is it performing correctly or not. Is it the correct code or not? Whether it's performing correct or not, is processing correctly or not, is called as the white box testing. Under the white box testing, several varieties. There are several varieties. But this is purely a one solid distinction of checking that software once it is ready, but before the development. We are more concerned with this one. We are more concerned with this aspect. This is totally not the case for us. This is where here the end user comes. Here the end user has checked it. But the software designer or the system engineer or the project manager or the project leader has checked this one. That is white box testing. As you can see there, in case of traditional methodology of testing, or till date, whatever we are following is the traditional. Of course, there are here or there some deviations in testing what we discussed yesterday. For time saving or cost saving. Other than that, this traditional or pedagogical method of testing, till date it holds good. Till date it holds good. For this whole testing, how it takes place, he has given in points or phases, different phases. But the same can be explained using a simple diagram, very simple diagram, a block diagram I can say. Instead of saying block diagram, even it may hold good, not it is, it may hold good as an UML diagram also. A model of the software testing process. He calls it as model of the software testing process. I don't call it as a UML, because in UML, definitely you are mentioning the exact processes. But here he generalizes. Here he generalizes. So that's what it's not called as an UML, but it's a similarity of a simile of the software testing phases. That is, the traditional software testing process, wherein you have to devise a test case based on the test design which you have taken into account, design the test cases, prepare the data. Once you have, what do you say, the particular module of the software in your hand, then design the test cases. Test cases are ready, then prepare a test data. Test cases and test data, a small difference. The case is a scenario. The case is a scenario. Based on that scenario, you have to produce a data, some set of data. So in the scenario, you have to put in the data. Then that data is going to be tested by the module. Then here, once the result comes out, you compare with the actual result with the expected result, any violation, any deviation, or any errors, or any mistakes, or any problem. Then you will be finding it out with your comments as a report. with a comment, it is called as report. If it is, even if both test expected result and the actual result both are same also, in the report you are writing it as it is satisfactory. Otherwise you have some comment saying here it needs, or it has got some violations, or it is making mistakes. So this is the core diagram of a software testing process as such, but we have some different diagrams for the individual testing methodology as such. This is the core diagram of software testing processes as taken as one model. If the question is draw the block diagram of a software testing process model and explain, then you have to draw this diagram with the saying that as a scenario and test data substituted, working out the results and comparing it with the actual result with the expected result and taking the output, the result, as one form of report you have to take out. This is the abstract you have to write for this diagram. Maybe the question will be for around 5 marks or so. Here the testing, in the development testing, before going to development testing, we have to consider the software as one commercial model. Software as one commercial model means an end user has given a software for development, and you have devised the software. It has to be tested based on the functionality or the requirement what the customer has specified. It has got, the title says, three stages of testing, or three strategies, the stages that we have to follow for the testing a commercial software. Anytime any developer, including Infosys, Mindtree, Logitech, or Global Edge, Infinity, whoever the software developer is, Phoenix or so, core software testing process should have these three phases. It is also called as the legacy or the pedagogy or the traditional software testing should have three phases. Those are, the first one is development testing, second one is the release testing, the third one is user testing. It should have three types of testing, these three phases, out of which the very first one, what just I was talking about, that is the development test. The development testing is where the system is tested during the development to discover bugs and defects we were talking about, and which helps actually both parties, that is the customer as well as the programmer, because we can cut down or we can totally vanish the errors or the mistakes, whatever the software may commit during the processing time for the required result. System designers, programmers and associated testers are likely to be involved in the testing process. You can see the wording here, that is likely to be, because it depends on the company, the software developer or the project owner, the time duration and the cost of software development. These all the factors influence who are all involved in testing. Because nowadays the designation itself is a software tester, a new designation in the industry is being developed, or it's already, most of the your seniors or our JIT alumni are joining the designation as software tester in the industries, big industries. So if there is a designation, then these, what you say, the programmers, associated testers and all, so these will not be necessary, because only one software or one expert software tester will be there involved with his assistants for checking any of the project or the modules being developed by the programmers. So programmers have no job of testing as such. But in case of there is no such option that tester is different from the programmer, then it is implied duty of the programmer itself that he has to recall or he has to revisit his program for testing. The second one means we are taking an overview of these three stages of testing. Once the software is tested by the programmer and associate tester or expert tester or what do you say, system analyst or the system administrator or the project manager, whoever responsible in the industry, then it is tested as part of development testing. During the development, it has gone through development testing. Then comes the question of now it is ready, it has to be released. It is about to be released, like a movie or like a, what do you say, any new product to the market, any, what do you say, cosmetic or fabric or any new product which is very attractive, which is catchy, and it's about to be released, it has to pass through some phases of testing. The similar way the software also, it has to pass through this release testing. Means it's about to be released to the market, but the last but one step, let us check one more time, because there should not be any feedback or there should not be any mistakes from the customer saying that the software is totally hopeless or it's not working efficiently. There should not be such comments by the end users or by the customers, because not only the comments, if software is involved in a commercial background or huge amount of finance matters related to, then it may commit lakhs of loss to the end user or a customer. Say maybe some big malls like the Big Bazaar or the DMart or any nucleus mall or somewhere, if it has got good amount of investment, it is your software is taken for suppose a billing or a commercial billing software, then if it makes a mistake in one small aspect of billing or where the finance matters are involved, it may lead to lakhs of loss. That should not occur. So last but one time, one more time, we'll check it out, release testing, where a separate testing team, see that, you can see this word, separate testing, here it is a tester. A separate testing, what is the meaning is, this time, separate testing team is done by the company with good experts, having good experience, and they have, they were part of the project, or they may not be part of project, but they have a good experience in testing the software of common trends in the scenario, so that they can check at the outset how best the software is performing at the outset. Means this I will refer with this wording, where it is, visual test. So visual testing, this word actually focuses on the testing team. Here I'll come over where it is separate testing team. They will check with the background how best it is performing. First, the software is at the outlook, it's having a good appearance and easy to use, user friendly. The third one, all the processes are going in a good or correct sequence. Fourth one, it's having a best performance and the good speed. Finally, it is performing whatever the speed or performance efficiency, but it should do it correctly, accurately. That's the purpose the separate testing team is taken into account, that is for the release test. The aim of the release testing is to check the system meets the end user requirements of the system or the stakeholder. The stakeholder, end user, the customer, all the wordings are same. Don't get confused. The stakeholder, the customer, or the end user, all are the same. I believe this about the release testing, the definition at the outset is clear to you. Then comes the third point, that is user testing, where the user or a potential user of the system test the system in their own environment. For software products, the user may be in an internal marketing group who decides if the software can be marketed, released, and sold. See, you can see the user testing. The user or a potential users of the system test the systems in their own environment for the software products. So then, what is release testing? Release testing is, here I can say, release testing inside the lab, and user testing on site of customer, means on the customer site or the end user on his site, he is checking his software, this software. The end user is checking the software on his site. Means suppose a Big Bazaar has given a contract to developing a software, commercial software of billing or some financial transaction analysis to suppose Infosys. Then Infosys tests the software before giving it to the Big Bazaar. That is release testing. Infosys checks at their end is release testing. Then user testing is Big Bazaar actually takes up that software, installs it and checks inside the Big Bazaar for their software performance, whatever the functionality they had told, they had asked, whether it's doing or not, the software is doing or not. Means software is performing or not, Big Bazaar expects it, they'll check for their expectance is user testing. In this user testing, after this full point, you can see that for the software products, the user may be an internal marketing group who decides if the software can be marketed, released and sold. Where it is, suppose the software is not developed for a particular specific customer, it is a generalized product, a general business commercial software, and it is checked by the marketing executives or marketing senior executives. They will check the software is based on the present market or a business scenario, it's performing best and it can be marketed, it can be sold and it can be released because it's having good functionality. So this is also be the possibility here. I can use the word the simulation. The word simulation means based on the present trends, the scenario or commercial aspects taken into account, your software which you have developed, a generalized commercial software you have developed, performs best, is checked inside the lab only, again inside the lab only, not at the customer site. It is checked inside the lab as in simulation. You can see the simulation of user testing is done. Got it? Well, we'll go ahead. That's the reason we go for checking an acceptance test. Once we have released or we have a consent or a permission or a permission granted from the experts saying that it can be released, then acceptance testing at the end user in a reality it has to be checked by the customer. In a reality it has to be checked by the customer so that he decides to accept the software. The title development testing, based on the three stages of testing for the software: development testing, second one is release testing, the third one is user testing. Inside the user testing, you have user acceptance testing also. The very first one is out of three stages, that is development testing. We'll go in detail. We are going in detail of the development test. As we know that development testing is done during the program, project or code development phases, or the module wise work distribution done in a project, Each module, during each module development, the individual programmer is going to check his own module and he submits the report to the his senior or a project manager saying that it is doing perfectly. Module is means modularized projects. Nowadays we are using object oriented programming as well. Very nice. But of course there are latest techniques also, the agile programming techniques, wherein you can make the processes faster also. It's beyond the object oriented programming. But taking object oriented programming into account, in general, the modularity or the work distribution done to different programmers for single project. One software, one project, the software is divided into different modules. Each module is tested by the individual programmer. For the individuals, there are three types of tests. For the individual, three types of testing. The testing should be done independently first, then afterwards integrating. The testing should be done independently first, then the testing should be done after integrating all the modules combined together. I'll show you the diagram. It's just a block diagram, but the project module 1, module 2, module 3, module 4, module 5. This is done by programmer 1, programmer 2, programmer 3, 4, programmer 5. And so it has to be tested 1 up to test 5. And integrating all these tests. Integrating all these tests and for the finalization. This is the only meaning. During the test 1, test 2, test 3, test 4, test 5, independent test, for individual modules, it may or may not apply, but it is categorized that it should be unit test. It's a unit testing. Then you may ask, unit this is the generalized meaning of the unit, that is, it is a module or a part or a separate process here or there, that is unit testing. That's the reason you can see there the individual program units, individual program units are taken into account for unit testing. Here we are, that is in development testing. Development testing, unit testing, second one, component testing. The last one is your system testing. The system testing. Testing is called as development testing. Development testing includes these three types of tests individually. The meanings are like this. Unit testing where individual programs, just now we discussed. And in this video, of course, you are looking into and you can download. Even later on, when you are in person, you can collect the PPT from me also. The words I have highlighted with a blue color, that is, what is the main intention of this part of unit testing is, it focuses on testing the functionality of the objects or the methods. Objects or the methods. You can see, earlier program or the old program module, wherein we divide a separate process as one of the methods or the functions, isn't it? In C program, earlier C programming all. After OOPS came into existence, we have a module, separate modules, and integrate those modules and call as and when required and produce the result. That is a new concept, or that it has become a tradition now for using object-oriented programming to produce the best result, and very, it is an optimal programming methodology also. Instead of cumbersome and which is confusing, the earlier methods, now the latest object-oriented programming is very best method, so that as and when the object is required, then only it saves your process time, it improves your efficiency, it improves the program efficiency, it improves the programming performance, and overall the best performing software it can be called when you are using object-oriented programming. So module wise, it focuses on testing the functionality for the objects or the methods. The method or an object or a specific task or a process or an individual program all mean the same. Then comes the component testing, where several individual units are integrated to create a composite component. Component testing should be focused on the testing component interface. Here, suppose in a web development, web programming, or you know nowadays that is on the front end, or a form filling on a Google form, whatever you are filling the data, you create a Google form and you key in. The front end is a Google form, at the back end Google uses its own database. The back end there are databases, the front end there is a front page or the HTML page, wherein you are keying in some data that goes, once you press submit, it goes to database. So the front end and back end, when you are clear about these two aspects, front end and back end, definitely there should be some, what do you say, interface. There should be some interface. How actually front end sends the database at the back end? So that is, there is some database connectivity methods or methodologies used. From the control panel, you have to do some settings, either ODBC or a JDBC, one or the other, some software processes, intermittent processes you have to take into account, or you have to integrate along with the front-end component, back-end component you have to use to integrate the software, or you have to interface the software. Then only front-end can send the database to back-end. Otherwise, to understand what is an interface, I'll tell you a simple example. I'm using the PowerPoint presentation over here. The interface is a simple cable, this cable with that LCD having projecting the complete my data or presentation from my screen to the LCD screen on this big screen over here. This is also one of the example of an interface. This is also one of the software, or it is developed for associating hardware and software together. It is formed as an interface. So the combination of the components which look after hardware or software, and the components, composite components means hardware and software together combined, or which take care of sending or receiving the data. That's also very important. Sending and receiving the data, that's there also the hardware and software plays a big role. All together called as the composite components, which is having an interfaces. Mostly interface, most of the time referred as an interface with a hardware, that is your HDMI connector or RJ45 pin connector or a USB component connector, or earlier days we connected without wireless, when it was the case, we connected a keyboard or a mouse with a keys, this USB connector. There are different interfaces associated with individual devices. Those all hardware interface or the software interfaces, what I just now explained, that is ODBC or JDBC, that interface ultimately to transmit data or accept the data also have to be tested under component testing. But before to that, whichever the modules taking care of all these issues, they have to be integrated. They have to be integrated, then it has to be tested. They have to be tested. Then the last part, that is the system testing, where some or all of the components in a system are integrated and the system is tested as a whole. System testing should be focusing on testing component reactions, component interactions. Here I have told very clearly, that is integration of the testing under one project, integrating all the testing under one project. This with this, this with this, with this, any combination, the data transaction or data transaction from here to here or here to here, it has to go very smooth. That is the interactions, ultimately the interactions have to be tested, system test. That is the system. The word system is the word project. Word project. System is project. A complete software, you can say. Development testing is a primary, a defect testing process, where the aim of our testing is to discover bugs in the software. In general, we can define. Means when we have a classification under the title of what is the commercial software, has to go into three stages of testing. Which one? First one is development testing, acceptance testing, and the user testing. User acceptance testing and the user testing, right? These are the three phases. Out of that, we are more concentrating on development testing. Under the development testing, again, we have three subdivisions, that is unit testing, component testing, and the system testing. Unit testing, component testing, and the system testing. If we are taking the three stages of testing under development testing alone, then how the development testing has to be termed as, means it is taken as primarily a defect testing process or a mechanism, where the aim of testing is to discover bugs in the software. It is to discover bugs in the software. Bugs is the mistakes or the problems with the processing are the main issues taken into account during development testing. So of course, this is nowhere taken as a definition, but it's just part of the implied meaning of what the development testing is. Then development testing, we'll go in detail. What is development testing? The first one is, as we have seen earlier in the previous slide, I have shown the unit testing, that is it is used an individual module or a program which has to be taken for testing, to focus on testing the functionality of objects and the methods. Functionality of objects and the methods. But which are the examples of such methods, or how the methods can be checked under unit testing in a project? The best example, here we can see, that is a weather station or weather forecasting station. The weather station forecasts the weather for the next day or days, and the prevailing, the present day, what exactly it is, and how actually the climate parameters will affect the weather, the temperature, humidity, the rains, the clouds, etc., etc. So which we are taking as one of the classic case study in our software engineering as a whole, in a subject, in the textbook Somerville, he has taken some two or three case studies as a whole. For any of the topics, he will take one or the other case study into detail for showing the best examples and its implementation. The example and implementation. Here, he has taken an example of weather station alone to show you the unit testing, how it takes into account. Suppose that the software is being developed is the weather forecast, or it is weather station functionality. You are developing a software which has got the modules, what I was talking about, module 1, module 2, module 3, I have shown several modules. The several modules, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 modules he has shown there. 7 modules he has shown there, sorry. 7 modules he has shown there, naming them as just one identifier. Naming them as identifier. Why he names it as identifier means, in overall functionality of the weather forecast station, this is a part of the function of the total weather forecasting station's complete processes. There are other aspects also you have to take into account apart from these objects. Apart from these objects, one more interesting issue is, this is a weather station situated at Belgaum, but the same weather station situated at some more nearby cities, and altogether these cities will send the feedback or send the data to the main climate controlling or forecasting station situated in our country's capital, or it may be some in metros, which controls all the servers, all the active workstations to forecast the weather. Whichever city you mention, it will give the details. Whichever city you mention, it will give the details. But for that weather station, these should be the parameters taken into account for forecasting the weather of the search. The identifier, the report weather may be one of, or report status may be one of the identifier. Means every time you call one or the other module or a program or the process from the controlling object to process that feature. What is report weather? It's a consolidated weather, today's weather forecast or weather, today's prevailing parameters, it will give you on the screen. So how this is represented, I will show you in the diagram. This is the state diagram of the weather forecasting station. The state diagram, what do you mean by state diagram? How individual object at the present situation, and how once the trigger to the individual module or a process takes into account, in what state it will starts working. The state diagram, it's a present and working state, means idle state and working state, how it changes from idle state to the working state based on the triggers it given by the end user. So the state diagram shows the controlling object, overall controlling object, when it starts running, weather station, when it starts running, a testing has to occur. Testing has to occur with claiming the report status, where the transmission of the tested results has to be given to the object, which passes to the controller. The summary, what is transmitted is the summary of the weather. Then how to pass the summary is based on the collecting factors. At what time, whether it is done or not, it is being checked and finalized. But before to that, anytime, it has to be configured for working. The workstation has to be done for working. The configuration has to be done. So the configuration with a controller